Today on BRStv, we're going to go over Kalkwasser, also known as calcium hydroxide or hydrated lime. Kalkwasser is one of my personal favorite ways to maintain calcium, alkalinity, and pH in most low to medium demand or mixed tanks. It's also one of the most affordable solutions. In today's video, we'll discuss what makes Kalkwasser an attractive solution, different ways to dose Kalkwasser to your tank, some basic precautions, a bit of science behind how it works, and finish with a few tips. To me, Kalkwasser is an attractive option because it raises calcium, alkalinity, and pH all with a single product. And it does all this while being one of the most affordable solutions available. There isn't a single other product out there that even comes close in this regard. It's also very easy for new reefers to use and understand. It doesn't require a ton of expensive equipment or knowledge to get set up like a calcium reactor does. And it doesn't require the use of multiple products like two-part. For many people, it's the only way they'll ever raise their pH consistently into the 8.2 to 8.3 range. Kalkwasser comes in a powder form and should never be added directly to the tank. You should first mix it with purified fresh water and saturate the solution. The liquid will be cloudy at first, but will eventually settle out over the course of a few hours. It's the clear solution that we want to dose, which is sometimes referred to as saturated lime water. You should avoid dosing the powder that settles out at the bottom because it can contain impurities and will likely raise your pH to an undesirable level. Because the saturated solution raises the pH so quickly, it's important to dose it rather slowly, typically over at least a few hours, but often longer. There are a few ways to do that. The first is build yourself a quick do-it-yourself dripper, which is just a jug with a small valve to control the drip rate. This is probably how a lot of people are first introduced to dosing Kalkwasser. It's fairly simple. Build one that's sized to your tank. Ideally, it should hold enough Kalkwasser solution to fulfill your tank's calcium and alkalinity needs for a day and not be larger than your tank would evaporate in a day. Just start the drip whenever you do your other daily maintenance like feeding the tank. Most people will have two, so they can mix the following day's solution at the same time and give it plenty of time to settle out before using it. You can also get a slow dosing pump and a timer, which will trigger the pump to turn on and off. However, the method that I personally like the most is coupling Kalkwasser with an auto top-off system, which automatically replaces the evaporated water. This means you'll have a single solution that solves a few major tasks, including maintaining calcium and alkalinity, elevating pH, and replacing evaporated water. The beauty of using an auto top-off system for this is evaporation naturally happens at a fairly slow rate. So this can be an ideal way to make sure the saturated Kalkwasser solution is added very slowly as well. One word of caution here, you will want to use a high-quality auto top-off system you trust. It can be a fairly big disaster if your top-off system fails in the on position and dumps a large volume of Kalk solution into the tank because the pH will skyrocket. My personal favorite is a Tunes osmolator, primarily because it's one of the few that has never failed me in the on position, but also because I really like that it uses two different technologies to measure the water level. The first is an electrical eye that has no moving parts to get stuck, and the backup level sensor is a common float switch. I also like the Elos top off for similar reasons. The small probe works off temperature and doesn't have any moving parts. It also has a backup mechanism programmed into it, which limits the volume of water added to the tank and will likely avoid a major disaster. One of the nice things about the Elos unit is how low profile the whole thing is. The tiny probe can fit in basically any sump, and in my opinion, the best solution for tanks without a sump. If you're running an inexpensive auto top-off that uses only float switches, which can and will eventually stick, or just looking for another level of security, you can always add a standalone pH controller or complete aquarium controller to the system to set it to turn the auto top-off system off if the pH ever gets too high. This is a good idea even if you have two float switches. Keep in mind that things like salt creep, power surges, and rogue snails, which can make one switch fail, can make the other switch fail as well. Another method of adding Kalkwasser is with the reactor or stirrer, which are somewhat similar. With both of these, you add a bunch of Kalkwasser to the bottom and mix the Kalk with fresh water to be slowly added to the tank. The primary advantage of using a reactor over a simple reservoir is you can hold a healthy amount of Kalkwasser in a small amount of space and ensure it's always completely saturated. It also limits the amount of carbon dioxide that Kalkwasser comes in contact with, which will help maintain potency. Reactors tend to use pumps to mix the solution, which works but has a few downsides. The pump will rapidly mix the kelk and water into a complete Kalkwasser slurry, which is okay, but you'll have to wait a few hours for it to settle out. You don't want to dose that slurry to the tank. This means you'll have to implement a series of timers to occasionally mix the kelk, as well as turn the feed pump on and off, so it'll never be on within a few hours of the last mixing cycle. Most people find this fairly undesirable. I'd also like to note that most mixing pumps that operate in a solution of saturated Kalkwasser will rapidly become covered in precipitate, so they require frequent maintenance or replacement. Stirrers work a bit differently. Rather than rapidly mixing the kelk with a pump, they use a slow-moving stir bar, which just keeps the bottom slightly moving. The feed pump pumps the water through the bottom so it has to pass through the portion that is mixing and ensures that it's fully saturated. Beauty of this is it shouldn't require any timers because only the very bottom of the reactor is ever filled with the slurry. The only time the slurry should ever hit the top and enter the tank is if you use too fast of a pump or too small of a stirrer for your size tank or typical evaporation. One thing to note about both stirrers and reactors is you can't control the potency of the solution. More or less, it'll always be fully saturated and at full strength. With the dripper or top-offs we mentioned earlier, it's easy to add less kelk to the solution when you mix it up to control the potency of the solution. Keep in mind that 2 teaspoons is the maximum amount that will dissolve in a gallon of water. As with everything, there are a couple of downsides. First, the powder is fairly caustic, talc-like, and easy to blow around. Most manufacturers will tell you to wear gloves, goggles, and a mask when handling it. It absolutely isn't the type of thing you want to breathe in or get in your eyes because it will burn. Depending on how sensitive your skin is, you might have issues there as well. Before using, check out the manufacturer's safety suggestions. The desirable effect of raising the pH is also a factor which limits how much you can add in a single day because we don't want the pH to go much over 8.3. So you might outgrow the solution when your tank becomes fairly heavily stocked. You can also be limited by the amount of water your tank evaporates. If your tank evaporates a half a gallon a day, that's also the maximum amount of saturated Kalkwasser solution you can add as well. There are, of course, ways to increase the amount of evaporation, but excess moisture can cause a variety of issues within your home, and it might just be better to switch to a different calcium and alkalinity solution if your tank outgrows this one. Time to include a little bit of science on how Kalkwasser works. Almost every other product out there that claims to be able to add calcium and alkalinity with a single product is just calcium carbonate in a bottle, which more or less is just pulverized sand. Since calcium carbonate doesn't dissolve in our tanks at a normal pH range of 7.8 to 8.3, most of these products are of low value. Kalkwasser is different from all of these products, and I believe the best one-bottle product that can effectively raise calcium and alkalinity in amounts useful to most reef tanks. Any product labeled Kalkwasser is really just calcium hydroxide, also often referred to as hydrated lime. Kalkwasser is a German word referring to the saturated solution you get when you mix the kelk with fresh water. Kalkwasser, or calcium hydroxide, is produced by heating calcium carbonate to over 1500 degrees, which liberates the carbon dioxide and produces calcium oxide. A small amount of water is then added to produce calcium hydroxide or hydrated lime, also known to the aquarium industry as Kalkwasser. What makes this such a cool product and different from those which attempt to dose calcium carbonate directly is when you mix it with fresh water, the calcium hydroxide ionizes into separate calcium and hydroxide ions. This obviously adds calcium, but when the hydroxide combines with carbon dioxide in the tank, it produces components of alkalinity like carbonate and bicarbonate, which our corals will use in conjunction with the free calcium ions to build their calcium carbonate-based skeletal structure. Beauty of all this is it adds these elements in a natural, balanced manner, and at the same time effectively removes carbon dioxide from the tank's water, which raises the pH, something basically all of us would like. A few last tips on using Kalkwasser. Interaction with carbon dioxide in the air and water will reduce the potency of the solution and even the powder itself. So for that reason, it's important to store the dry product with the lid tightly secured. If you mix and store the fluid in a large container, it's also a good idea to put a lid on that container to minimize the gas exchange. However, a thin crust will likely form on the surface, which will protect it to some degree as well. When mixing, just give it one good vigorous mix and let the powder settle. You don't want to use pumps or air stones to mix the water after that, because it will just add unwanted carbon dioxide and reduce the potency of your kalk solution. Lastly, while Kalkwasser is a great tool to replace the small amounts of calcium and alkalinity consumed by your corals each day, it isn't a very good tool to make large adjustments because you can't add enough to make a big difference without raising the pH too much. Most reefers will adjust the calcium and alkalinity levels to where they want them using calcium chloride and sodium bicarbonate or their favorite two-part additive because it's possible to add more of these in a single dose without affecting the pH significantly. They then use Kalkwasser to maintain these new levels on a daily basis as the corals consume small amounts each day. That about wraps up today's episode. This week's question of the week is, what is your favorite auto top-off system and would you consider using it with Kalkwasser? Next week, we're going to do an in-depth episode on two-part as well as a short video on calibrating your dosing pump. If you'd like to be notified when these come out, hit the subscribe button. Thank you for watching BRStv.